In this next lesson, we're going to generate regeneration data for analysis. And we'll do this by backfilling the event frame records from the analytic we've just created. So back in PiSystem Explorer, we're in the management view where we can see all of the analysis that are being run for this particular AF model. And what we'd like to do is start up the My Dryer Regeneration events we have for dryers A and B that we just created and backfill them for 2019 so we can create some event frames. So the first step is to select those analytics from the list and then go over and enable them, which starts them up and gets the AF analysis services connected in and makes them ready to go. So once we get the green check marks, we'll move down to the backfilling menu here and click queue and fill in the start time and end times to be 2019. Check the permanently delete box because we want everything cleared out. These are new event frames. We don't want any of the old ones. There aren't any in this case, but if there were, it gets rid of them. Hit the queue button. Let the analytic backfill. Okay, it appears to be done. We have the backfilling check marks lit up there. Now, I'm going to go ahead and disable this analytic since I don't want it to keep running. And now we're ready to take a look at what we've generated. So to do that, you want to move over to the event frames view of PiSystem Explorer, and we're going to want to search the event frame records. So in order to do that, if you right-click where it says Event Frame Searches and select New Search, it'll bring up a dialog which gives you quite a bit of different criteria to select to find the event frames you're interested in. So it could be the name. This is where the naming is important. Could be the category. You can see the various things that you can specify. But for this example, we're going to just use the event frame template. So we'll select My Dryer Regeneration Cycle and hit search. And you can see it's found 423 event frames. So that's good. That sounds about right. You'll notice that we just have three columns because that's the basic information that comes with an event frame by default. The name, the duration, start and end times. But we've added other attributes for these event frames through the template. To get to those, you select the little gear icon over here and go down and select attributes. Okay, from this dialog, things look a little more familiar because now we can see the attributes that we configured as part of our event frame template. Let's go ahead and pick all of them and hit OK. Okay, there we go. So there's the data that we'll be using for our analysis in the next step. If we go ahead and click OK, then we see this view that gives us a view of all the event frames we just generated. So we're really in a point now where we've contextualized the data. We've done some data engineering to calculate some things. We've got the status created so we can generate event frames. And then through the event frames, we could connect not just totals, but records that contain information about each dryer regeneration for the entire year. And the next step we're going to do is to take this data, extract it using the Pi Integrator for Business Analytics, and try to build our predictive model. And then from that predictive model, we'll operationalize it and then set up notifications to let operators know when it's time or when the best time is to regenerate the dryer.